Hello everybody, Lurks here, welcome to my channel, and today it's how to get your iPhone iCloud photos and videos from your iCloud down to your computer. Now there's quite a few different ways to do this and I'll show you two options today. Option one is to download all your iCloud photos down to your iPhone and then copy them from your iPhone to your computer. But this is very risky because if you move all your photos and videos to your local iPhone, it can fill up. And you know what happens when the iPhone fills up? It crashes. But I will show you how to do that anyway. And option two is to log into the iCloud and download all your photos and videos from your iCloud to your local computer. And if you want to do it that way, you can just skip to that chapter and I'll put the chapter in the description. I'll show you option one first of all and show you what was happening. Plug in the iPhone into your desktop PC or your laptop. And when I went into File Explorer and explored the iPhone in the folders, I'm clicking in the recent folders. And there's photos and videos which aren't appearing in here, but they're definitely on the iPhone. So I go to the iPhone, go to photos, and I've got this group of photos and videos here. And when I look in File Explorer on the Windows PC, they do not appear. Now this is because these videos and photos aren't actually on my iPhone. They're actually on the iCloud. And the way you can prove this is at the top, if you select edit, you'll notice when I select edit, it says in the middle, downloading. So what it's doing, it's downloading that video clip from the iCloud to your local iPhone. So then you can edit it. You've probably got hundreds and hundreds of videos and photos on the iCloud. Now what you can do is go into settings on the iPhone, scroll down to photos, select photos, and you've got this option, optimize iPhone storage or download and keep originals. Now, if you select download and keep originals, what it will do then is it will start downloading everything from the iCloud to your local iPhone. And if you look at the top left hand corner, you can see the spinning round egg timer, which means that it's downloading everything from the iCloud to your local iPhone. Now, this is not a good option because what will happen is your iPhone will quickly fill up and then it will most likely crash. So I wouldn't really recommend selecting that option. But if you do select that option and you've got plenty of space on your iPhone, what will happen is when you go to your File Explorer on your Windows computer, those video clips and photos will start appearing in that File Explorer folder. And then you can just select those and copy them to your PC. So those are the clips there that were on my iPhone, which I couldn't see before. So you can just select those using your mouse. Then I'm just going to right click and then select cut. And then go to the folder on my Windows computer that I want to move them to. Right click on the mouse and select paste. Now that is one way of doing it, but as I mentioned, I wouldn't recommend doing that unless you've got a huge amount of memory on your iPhone. So select back to optimize iPhone storage. Now we'll do the second option, which is to download anything that you need from your iCloud account. Go to your desktop PC or your laptop, go to iCloud.com, sign into your iCloud. This will be your Apple ID and your Apple password. Then select that arrow. You will now get a verification code popping up on your iPhone. This is to say that someone's trying to get into your iCloud. Type that verification code into the web browser, then press enter. Now it's verifying. Do you trust this browser? Yes, because I'm sitting here. And now you're logged into your iCloud account. There's lots of different settings in here, but we're interested in photos. So select photos. When you go into it, it defaults to moments. So at the top, if you select photos, that will give you all photos. And this is every single photo on your iCloud. So if we go to the scroll option on the right hand side, I'm going to scroll all the way to the top. And this one is going all the way back to 2016. And we've got some photos here. And I want to select one of these to download to my computer. This is the photo that I want to save to my computer. If you right click on this picture here and click Save Image As, you can save the thumbnail, but it won't be very big. So what you need to do is double click into the photo and then select this option on the top right hand corner, which is download the photo. And you can see in the bottom left, it's downloaded img_2869. Now if we go to File Explorer on the computer, look at the downloads, click on refresh, img2869, look at that, it's 3.74 megabytes, which is the full resolution picture. If you want to download multiple photos and videos, that's actually really easy. Hold down the control key on your keyboard and with your mouse, select all the photos and videos that you want. So I've got four selected here. Again, click on the download icon at the top. That will download the items that you have selected. So in the bottom left, it's downloaded it as a zip file. Then if we go to File Explorer, go to Downloads, double click on the .zip file that's just been downloaded. Select the iCloud Photos folder. Then select Extract 2. I'm just going to extract this one video clip and three photos to the Downloads folder again. Click on OK. Now if we go to the Downloads folder, right click, click on Refresh. We've got three photos here, all at full resolution from the iCloud and the full resolution video clip. So we can just double click on the video clip. And that is how you download multiple photos and videos from your iCloud account. Fantastic. And I tell you what, that definitely deserves a lovely cup of tea. But first, remember to log out of your iCloud account. You do this in the top right hand corner. Select your name. Then click on sign out. What you can also do to make it easier is you can download iCloud for Windows, and then it will automatically sync with your Windows PC. So you could also look into that option. Time for a brew. Oh. I hope you found that useful. Over here is a link on how to send voice memos from your iPhone to your computer. And up on this side, there's a link on what to do if your iPhone to laptop hotspot is not working properly. Thanks for visiting my channel, everyone. I really, really appreciate it.